filling out the Forum, you know, first Madison Square Garden, now the Forum. And he's doing it because the fans just want to see him in the ring, regardless of who he fights against.
Tom, obviously.
Dante's Boxing Nation.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? Well, I tell you, today is definitely a very, very interesting day in the sport of boxing. We had two great press conferences, Adrian Broner versus Adrian Granados out in Cincinnati. And we have the real big, the biggest middleweight fight of the year, of course, which is Golovkin versus Danny Jacobs press conference. Finally, they face off. This was a highly anticipated press conference and face-off, and, you know, it didn't. I like the fact that they opened up questions to the media. And, you know, it was interesting because someone asked Gennady Golovkin who was the hardest puncher he ever faced. And I thought his answer or his response to that question was a little odd because he was asked who was the hardest puncher he ever faced. And for some reason, Gennady Golovkin, he understood the question because it was translated to him, but he didn't want to reveal who was the hardest puncher he ever faced. He just basically said, oh, you know, everyone has power. I've never been knocked down before. It just makes me wonder why, you know, he didn't want to just be a little humble when it came to that question and just be like, oh, it was this guy, it was that guy. Because we already heard, I believe it was his trainer, and not Golovkin, who already said that Curtis Stevens was the hardest puncher. So the fact that they have already said something like that on record before, and now Golovkin, he doesn't want to reveal it, is pretty interesting to me. And, you know, they asked Danny Jacobs, you know, what did he learn from his loss against Pyrog? And, of course, he just said, you know, he learned to make sure that he's mentally ready for anything. And it's so funny that he brought up the psychological aspect of things, because I was just talking about on the radio show just the other day, I was just saying this is going to come down to how strong Danny Jacobs is psychologically. You know, how is he going to deal with getting hit by Golovkin for the first time? Is that going to make him fight harder and better, or is he going to cave under pressure? And is he going to become gun shy like David Lemieux did? That's a question that will be answered in March. The press conference definitely succeeded expectations. When they faced off for the first time, they both looked ready, despite the fact that Danny Jacobs has been knocked out before and he's a heavy underdog in this fight. You can see this is definitely a different type of opponent that Gennady Golovkin is used to facing. Now, once again, we really don't know if Danny Jacobs, everyone keeps talking about Danny Jacobs' chin, everyone keeps questioning his chin. You know, there's been professional fighters like Curtis Stevens. He even said that, you know, Danny Jacobs' chin won't hold up. So we'll see. I'm not ready to say Danny Jacobs doesn't have a chin, because just being knocked out doesn't suggest you don't have a chin. I said it before and I'll say it again. Manny Pacquiao, he was knocked out twice before he reached pound-for-pound status. And Manny Pacquiao has one of the best chins in the sport of boxing, despite being knocked out three times. So we'll see, guys. We'll see what happens. And that's all I got for now, and I'm on to the next one.
Hi, you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation. Woo!